Hello, my friends, it's Dani, and today I am showing you how to make steel-cut oats three different ways. So the first technique that I'll show you is the traditional stovetop technique. Then I'm gonna show you how to make them in your crock pot. This method is great for meal prep. And I'm also gonna show you how to effortlessly make them overnight. Now, just as a reminder, steel-cut oats are the whole oat groat cut into smaller pieces with a steel mill. They are the least processed form of oatmeal, so they do take the longest to cook, but they also digest slower, and they have a really hearty, creamy, delicious texture that is so worth the wait. So let's get started with the traditional stovetop method for making steel-cut oats. Here I've got a 5-quart pot. You could also use a pot that's a little bigger than this. And to that I'm adding 2 cups of water and 2 cups of unsweetened vanilla almond milk or any other milk that you fancy. I find that the almond milk adds a nice light sweet flavor and helps to make the oats just a little bit creamier, but they're also absolutely delicious made with all water. Or if you wanted to make it a little richer, you could do all milk. Everything works here. Personally, I like to cut the difference and go 50-50. Bring that up to a boil and then slowly stir in 1 cup of steel-cut oats along with a pinch of kosher salt. I give that a gentle stir, allow everything to come up to a boil, and then reduce this down to a gentle simmer and set your timer for 20 minutes. Now, I like to periodically stir the oats at the beginning here because right at the beginning, they have a tendency to want to foam up and potentially come up over the pot. So you just want to keep an eye on them. But once that simmer starts rolling, it's pretty much hands off. After the 20 minutes, you're gonna see that the oats have thickened up and they're gonna be nice and rich and creamy. And at this point, they will be pretty chewy, kind of like al dente, which is exactly how I like them. But if you want them to be a little softer and a little more tender, you could let them go for an extra 5 or 10 minutes. That part is complete personal preference. Once you have your oats right where you like them, you can serve them up with some of your favorite toppings. We like berries and nuts and maple syrup in this house. But you can also let the oats cool completely and then transfer into some airtight containers and use them as a head start ingredient throughout the week. Making them ahead of time when you do your meal prep is a great way to enjoy the hearty steel-cut oats during busy mornings when you might not have the time to make them from scratch. Now, the next option you have is your crock pot, but you want to make sure that before you get anything in the crock pot that you grease it up. You could either do coconut oil, you could do butter like I'm using here, or you could do a cooking spray. The oats do tend to want to stick to the crock pot, so just make sure that you use something to help prevent that. Then I'm adding in 2 cups of water and 2 cups of almond milk, along with 1 cup of steel-cut oats, a pinch of kosher salt, and then totally optional, but absolutely lovely, a cinnamon stick. Pop on a lid, and then you can either cook this on high for about 2.5, 3 hours, or on low, anywhere between 4 and 6 hours. I recommend checking your oats at the earlier side of the cooking because all crock pots vary with their heat, so you want to keep an eye on them. I personally don't like doing the oats in the crock pot overnight because it tends to be done way before my sleep cycle is over. So the only way that would really work is if you had a crock pot where you could program the time into it. Now you're going to know that your oats are ready when they're nice and rich and creamy and tender. Now, I personally like this method the best if I'm doing meal prep because you can make a whole bunch in the crock pot, set it up in the morning, and then a few hours later when it's done, you can just let it cool down and divvy it up into containers. So it's super easy peasy. Can I please get a big thumbs up for all my 6 to start meal preppers out there? And then the last technique that I want to share with you guys is the most effortless way to make your oats, and that is to make them overnight on the stove. Don't worry, you don't need to leave your stove on. Here's what you do. So you wanna get a nice, big, heavy pot like I have here. And into that, I'm doing 4 cups of water. I'll bring the water up to a boil. And then once it's boiling, I'm gonna stir in 1 cup of the steel-cut oats along with a pinch of kosher salt. Give that a stir, let it come back up to a boil, which happens very quickly. Then I shut off the heat and pop on the lid. That is it. Then you can go to sleep and do whatever it is you do. And by the morning, the oats will have absorbed all of that liquid and they'll be nice and tender and creamy. All you have to do is pop the stove on for a few minutes, maybe add an extra splash of water or milk to loosen the oats up. And in about 5 minutes later, your oats will be hot and steamy and heated through, and you'll have fresh cooked steel-cut oats ready to go. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Now, I do want to address the microwave really quick before we wrap this video up, because a lot of things that I read, including the back of the oatmeal canister, say that you can make steel-cut oats in the microwave. I personally have never had any success. I cannot find a container that is tall enough to make the oats in the microwave without them always pouring over in the microwave. So it doesn't work for me, but apparently it could work. So I'm curious to know if any of you have tried that method and found a way to make it work. If so, share all of your wisdom and your brilliance down in the comments below. All of us in the C&D community would greatly appreciate it. So my friends, now that you have three, potentially four techniques for making your steel cut oats, I'm so curious to know which one you think you'll try first and what are your favorite oatmeal toppings? Comment down to the comments below and please share. And don't forget to snap a picture of your oatmeal and tag us on Instagram and on Facebook using the hashtag clean and delicious so we can see everything you're whipping up in your very own kitchens. And my dear friend, if you haven't already, please take a moment to like, subscribe, and share this video with anybody else you know who wants to make healthy eating easy. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Dani Spees and I will see you back here next time with some more clean and deliciousness. Cheers. Are the whole oat groat that has a programmable timer on it. Programmable, ready? It had a programmable, programmable.